Before we get into today's video, I wanted to talk about one of the best ways to save money on Evony packs. We all know that buying packs is the best way to turbocharge your growth, and it's always better to save money while getting the same rewards. US customers can get 25% back on all Evony purchases made through the Amazon App Store. To take advantage of this awesome deal, follow three simple steps. Number one, install the Amazon App Store on your Android device or BlueStacks emulator. Two, download Evony through the Amazon App Store. And three, purchase packages in Evony to get 25% back in Amazon coins. Additionally, this time, Amazon has provided a mechanism to pre-register to avoid any payment issues. The link is in the description of the video. I've also put the link to this website in the description of the video. This website includes QR codes to download and buy Amazon coins and an in-depth set of instructions on how to get Amazon App Store set up. Make sure to take advantage of this amazing deal while it lasts. Hello everyone, welcome back to Optimize Evony. Today I wanted to do a quick video on this massive update that Evony has just released. It is the anniversary event, as you know, a lot of people had foretold. So there's a lot of new stuff going on here. I'm gonna touch on kind of the highlights with it. And then I'll probably do some follow-up videos to touch up on some of the stuff that I skipped over a little bit. But basically, some of the big things is that we'll go into the actual anniversary event stuff a little bit later. There is one, a new dragon, and that you can get that in the Dragon War event, which is in the valuable event here. Basically you need to get to this, this pattern, Radiant Worm pattern, I guess. And then, yeah, using that, you can unlock the dragon in your pasture. Let's take a quick look at the buffs. So this is, at level 20. You get marching mount troop defense, mount troop HP, enemy siege HP, which is super interesting. This tells me that it's more of a sub-general dragon than an attacking general dragon for a lot of people. I mean, these stats are okay, but I mean, it's tough to get siege HP, and there's a lot of other mount dragons in the game. So let's look at the talents. Again, debuffs here. Yes, then you have some positive buffs for mounts. So it looks like it's really debuffs or mount buffs. So again, marching mount troop defense. And this one's good because it's an activatable skill. So even if you're not using that dragon, you will get this 24% marching mount troop defense and the 30% in city mount troop attack. These aren't crazy good for an activatable skill, but yeah, it definitely looks like it's a debuff dragon, at least for me. Like there's probably some people that would need to use it for attacking, but yeah. I haven't calculated how much it would actually cost to get that, but I think it's usually somewhere between like 200, 250 if you're spending on that event itself. The other thing, we'll kind of keep going with this dragon level cap increase. So we'll take a look at the dragon levels, or the, you know, pasture and dragon cliff and stuff like that. But basically the big thing is that you are going to now be able to feed and go from level 15 to level 20, which increases, you know, your buffs and stuff like that for it. But maybe is a good thing. I kind of like dragon levels because it's something that you can actually do free to play. You don't need to have, you know, be spending to get a dragon to level, you know, 15 before, you know, it'll take time to get it to 20, but it's not something that you just like cannot get, that's behind a paywall. Oh, the other thing here, package value boost. if you take a look at these extra return things here, they have been kind of slowly going up. I think the last one was maybe like 80 or 85%, but now it's up to 90,000%, which is just absurd. It's crazy how they calculate this. It's really not like it's you're getting that much of a value. They're basically comparing it to the amount of gems that you're getting, and they're vastly overvaluing some of these things. But let's look at where they actually improve things. So you still get an optional chest, you still get, premium gear, you still get the same amount of military treaties and optional chests here, still get the same number of barb tokens. I'm not sure how many were here. That looks like it's maybe a little bit of an increase. Same amount of meteoric stones, not sure on the blood crystals. Blood of Ares, I think it was similar. Maybe that's a little bit of an increase. But I don't know. It doesn't seem like it's a crazy amount of increase. There is a little bit of additional increase in the optional chest. So here it, there this is a little bit more than what you were getting before. I really only noticed because I think the tactic scrolls used to be under 400. So if you tripled it, it would be like 1,000 or something like that. But now this will be up to like 1,200. So not that much of a difference. So if you got excited by that, it's not a crazy amount of increase. Champion level increase goes up to 28 from 20. So this is another pretty big increase, where it used to be capped at 20. Let me quick join these pans. Need those need those tactic scrolls for all of the research. Okay, so the champions now go up to 20. So if you look at the skill, it now goes up to, sorry, 20, 28, 26, one of those two. But basically, two more levels on each one. So I guess it would be 28, because there's four of them. And there are pretty significant increases. So you basically double your reinforcement capacity from 20 to 20, whatever this is, probably 26 or something, that you're going to be getting that. And yeah, it does go up quite a bit, but I'm assuming the amount that you actually have to feed it goes up a decent amount as well. The other thing that I did notice here, which is a little bit of a bummer, if you notice going up to level 20, you got these premium general tokens, which were a good way for free-to-play players to be able to save up for opening a bunch of general tokens to get, enough copies of generals to ascend them, and stuff like that. And it was really one of the only chances that you would get general tokens in the game. After level 20, you no longer get them. You're still getting your Blood of Ares. You are now getting blood crystals, and yeah, I don't know. I don't know what to think about this. I kind of like the general tokens because they're constantly releasing new generals that are better, that have are a couple hundred percent increase over generals that I've maxed. But ultimately it is just kind of a rat race there. So it's nice to be able to have the general tokens to open them, to hopefully get enough copies to 10 star a general if a really good one comes out. But you do need to really save those for the good generals. Don't open them on any event, or don't open them on just when you get them, because that's no longer really the meta, because you need so many copies of the generals to actually ascend them. So yeah, I guess let me know what you think about that cap increase and stuff like that. There is a new champion, as kind of assumed. Here are the skills. So this is overall ranged troop and siege HP. So that's good for attacking, defending, overall basically, which is really good because you want that siege HP on defense if you're trying to take, if you're getting attacked with siege and stuff like that. Attacking debuff, that's not super important, I don't think. Training speed, not super important with the amount of training speeds that you can get from Pans and Cerberuses and stuff like that. This is pretty decent. Defending ground troop and mount troop defense and HP, but it's pretty similar to ones that we already have. So it's really kind of this first one that I'm a little bit excited for. There is also a there's also a no, that's not how you do it. There is a, how do I get to it? There is a skin for this, I believe. It's not showing up there for me right now. Maybe there's going to be another update, but basically how you get that again is from the basically coining King's Party. If you get to Cake level 5, you get this bath invitation that unlocks Marcia. So if you are looking to spend, this is not a bad event to spend on. It is, usually you get a pretty decent amount for your money. You're getting a new champion. You're potentially getting a new dragon, particularly if you need an additional dragons to get to that three, four, or six dragons at level 15 for those buffs. That's pretty important. It's not a bad event to spend. Remember, if you are spending, do use Amazon App Store because you can get up to, I think it's like 39% back in Amazon coins. Of course, that's been on the beginning of my videos for quite some time. That's going until the end of the year. So let's get into the actual 8th anniversary event. This is typically, kind of you break down into a bunch of different events. There's, shared gems, all kinds of stuff here. I'm not going to go through all of it. One thing to note, don't forget to do the gladiators trial. This is, like the where you have to go into the trial and you have to answer questions and stuff like that. Usually Theria Games has kind of the answer key for that. So double check there. Here is the new assistant general. Almost all of these are actually assistant generals. Sigurd, Melisandre, but also if you needed one of these, you can pick it up again. One of the interesting things is Eleanor and Alessandra are no longer on there, which they used to be. So just interesting to note. She seems like a pretty good assistant ground general. Has 10% of march size capacity here for assistant, not overall, not really anything useful in overall, just training speed and stuff like that. Of course, they always tie the special gens together with the general that you're technically supposed to be using them with, which is this new guy, but doesn't have a lot of it isn't as crazy march speed or march size heavy as I was kind of expecting. It does have it here, which is nice. But yeah, I'll do another video on the new generals once I get some time to actually do some calculus and figure out if they're how much better they are and if they're actually worth getting for a new ground setup. I actually badly need a new ground setup because I'm still using Elise and Alessandra, and she's what, 3 years old now. So there's definitely a lot of buffs that I can get by upgrading. Here again, you choose a side and then you basically get some rewards there. This is very similar to how it's been in the last event. Usually people pick the left side, but we'll see. One thing you can do to figure out which side has more, because basically the side that has more is only going to keep getting more as people use these things every day and give more to their camp. You can join both sides with alts and see which one's ahead, and then on your main you can pick whichever one is ahead to make sure that you get the best rewards there. The other thing, of course, is the Hall of Champions. This is where you basically can get the keep event, and also you can redeem for a whole bunch of exciting things here. These are like the new super duty general kind of things, and this guy in particular is great because he gives additional rally cap if you're a rally setter, but it's only at the 10 star, so you're gonna need to get a lot of these to get there, and you can only get two of them here. So let's take a look at the actual rewards here. We've talked about the champion skin. Oh, here's where the champion skin actually is. So here we can actually see it. Reinforcing ground troop and mount troop attack 10%, and then enemy range troop and siege machine attack debuff 5%. So not bad, but probably not worth how much they're selling it for. New ideal land ornament, that's great, sure. General skins, so this is for the new general, and it doesn't actually say its buffs here, but again, like I said, I will do a video on the new pairing to see how they stack up against some of the other ground generals. The other thing is the new castle decoration. So as I'm sure all of you guys know, at the anniversary events, they have these castles with activatable skills and different tiers. And basically how you get that is that competition I'll show you again after this. But let's look at the buffs here. So level one buffs are not particularly amazing, except for it does give you a little bit of ranged troop attack, just owned to activate, which is nice. Otherwise, it's pretty meh in terms of actual buffs here. The second one is a little bit better. You get 10% ranged troop attack debuff, and starting to get a little bit better ground troop used to activate stuff. It still doesn't really look like a good one to actually use to activate. And then kind of the final level, which is top three, I believe, in that competition, you get 15% ranged troop attack. Wow, they've really made this hard to read. And then ground troop and mount troop attack for your alliance, 10%, and you can get three stacks of that. So if three people in your alliance place in the top three, you're getting 30% ground troop and mount troop attack overall. So that's defending, offense, all of that, which is nice, but that requires you to have some pretty big spenders in your alliance. Again, overall, the buffs are not that great here. The only thing that people are going to be getting this for is that own to activate skill. And then this skill. This is the activatable skill, which is increase attack, defense, and HP of ground troops of you and your allied players within 6 grids of you by 60%. Even that's not that great compared to some of the other ones. Let's look at the second skill because you also get this here. It's basically the same thing except for 40%. But yeah, I mean that's nothing compared to. Let's go back here. That's nothing compared to this one, which was the last one, which At the level 3 one you get, enemy siege machine debuff there. You get in rally range troop attack 20% instead of 10% for your entire alliance, again up to 3 stacks. You get, some of these nice things, but again, that only applies when you're actually using the castle. This is the real kicker. You get 100% more range troop attack for the people around you. It does reduce your range troop defense and HP by 20%, but that's fine for the additional attack. So basically, it gives you 120% attack for your alliance when you activate the skill, which is crazy compared to the 60% for ground troops. Which ground troops, unless you're soloing, smaller keeps, you're probably not using ground all that much, at least for attacking. Maybe you're reinforcing with it, but yeah, I don't know. Castle doesn't look that great. It would still be nice to get one in your alliance for those owned activate buffs, but probably not worth how much people are going to be spending for it. That's kind of the main thing here. There is a new boss that's essentially just like one of those like the searcher or like the other things that drop the decorations that you put on people's keep for 5 minutes. So not anything too crazy there. But yeah, that's kind of the main part of this update. I am sure that I have missed something. I'm doing this essentially right after the update has launched, so I'm sure there's going to be things that I find out more. Like I said, I'll do more on like the generals and where I think it makes sense to actually spend on it, and what champions I think make sense to max out or to push with these new updated champion levels. But yeah, thanks for watching. As always, please remember to like and subscribe. I am trying to push my subscriber count. I'm trying to get to 5,000 subscribers by the end of the year. I'm pretty close, but it is, I don't normally chase subscribers, but it is kind of a cool milestone. So thank you for all the people who have already subscribed. And of course, you don't have to, but it does help me out. And it's kind of a cool metric, shows that people are finding this useful. But yeah, thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.